Now, welcome to a part two of a lesson preparation. Yeah, this is the second phase. Now we went through the first phase where I explained these are the easiest thing that you have to include in, and now we move on the challenging part of the lesson plan now, where most of students get it challenging when it comes to this second phase. Now this is the lesson phase, is the lesson itself now. Those are only, let me say, the basics, but this one you are in too deep a lesson. We are into the lesson deeply. Now as you see here, there is time, the skill, strategy, and integration. I believe the new forms which you were given, they are there's a part whereby, I mean, before you get lesson phase, there's a part whereby you, I mean, where all of these things are explained in details there. But for me, I'm only going to touch a bit on the important part that you have to include in your lesson plan. Now here, I only chose time which is 5 minutes, and the skill is speaking and responding. And for the strategies, yeah, this one, see, it can be singing, homeworks, integration, all that. I think they are all in that file that we're given, all of you. Now we move to the lesson content. Lesson content and vocabulary. So this is the introduction, so to say. The introduction. This is the introduction. It was supposed to be in bold. Don't know what happened. Supposed to be bold. So this is the introduction now. So now under introduction, introduction is like you are awakening the awareness of the students or the learners in the class. Now what are you going to do in introduction? That depends to you as a teacher. Do you remember when we were in junior primary schools? A teacher will come in class. He or she will introduce the lesson with a song or with a story, interesting story, or maybe a recap of what she taught us or he taught us the previous day. Now here in this column you don't write the activities. What you have to do, lesson content, what are you going to do in introduction? So are you going to sing a song and ask questions on the previous topic, or tell the story? And now in this case, I chose a song which was Butterfly. I believe, okay, this is a new song, Butterfly. It's called Butterfly. And after the lesson content, after the Butterfly, now I'll ask questions. Now what did the learner hear in the song? What was the meaning, the name of the animal that was mentioned in the song? Plus, I forgot to include vocabularies. Vocabularies, they might be difficult words in the song, so you have to specify it down here. Let me say, you have to put them down here. Let me say, okay. Vocabularies. Now under here is like you specify now the vocabulary. Let me say, butterfly, you explain the meaning of butterfly. Wings, you explain the meaning of wings. Now here the teachers on the teachers, let me just undo this. On the teacher's activity and media and methods. Okay, here the teacher leads the song. What the teacher is going to do? The teacher will lead the song. Now the learner, what will the learner do? The learner will also sing after the teacher. The teacher will go first, he will lead the song, then the learner will seen after the teacher, just like that. They should correlate with the points. Let me say this is the song, so this one should also correlate with the song also. It will go in the line just like that. Needs the song, sing after the head, I mean the teacher. Now the question C. Okay, you just say question C. Now what are you going to do now in your section as a teacher? What are you going to do? Now the teacher asks questions about this song. These are the questions that the teacher is going to ask. This ones they are the questions. Now here Lena. Okay, Lena answers the question. Example: flutter around, touch the ground, butterfly. Cause okay, because this was the it was the song that we sang during our micro teaching. The title, it was just butterfly. So just ask now what anything. So the learner will just answer now. Maybe example: flutters around, touch the ground, and then the fly. What this one? And the yeah. And from there we are done with this section. Remember, this section is done already. It's for introduction. This one. Now we go on the section of development. Development is like you are going into the detail. I mean into detail now for the detail for the topic or lesson that you are teaching. Now here. Explains the vocabularies, what I told you here. So you explain the vocabulary now as you are teaching, because there might be those difficult vocabularies, so you should explain them to learners as you are teaching. Explain them to learners as you are teaching. Yes, I wrote this one here, bullet here. Yeah, just like the T, wait, T. Wait, okay. So this one was supposed to be down here. It is this point. Then this one come back. Come back so they are together. Okay, here the teacher. Okay, explanation. This section for development, you teach, but as you are teaching, what are you going to teach? Everything like that. So the teacher explains the theme. This theme now, metamorphosis. The teacher explains the theme. So learner listen. They listen and they ask. Wait. They listen and ask questions. Questions. No, learners will listen and ask questions. It's like that. Now we come to description here. Wait, description, just wait a bit. Yeah, okay. Description and displaying pictures of the four stages, example: egg, caterpillar or larva, pupa, and adult butterfly. Now, here, what the teacher is going to do, because this only say that okay, the teacher is going to display this. Now, the teacher is going to display pictures and describe. The pictures one by one. So the learner observes the process. Learner observes the process. They just observe the process to see how the caterpillar. I mean, yeah, it's like the caterpillar turns into a butterfly. So they just observe. And we come now under reinforcement. As I told you guys earlier, of course, this is the only a brief. If you have questions, please drop them under the, I mean, into the comment section. Just like that, here is 5 minutes, because it's introduction, 15 minutes, because it's development, it's teaching. So teaching obviously for 15 minutes, unless the learners are too slow to catch. Just like that. Now we come under reinforcement. Reinforcement now is where you give activities, homeworks, or quiz, or anything that you normally see, anything regarding activities, quizzes, any assessment that you are going to give. So you also are going to give them 15 minutes. The skills: listening and responding, close exercise, which means learners going to do it individually. So the teacher, I mean, these are the activities, filling the missing words and terminologies. So the teacher will give instructions to learner how, I mean, to learners how to do the activity. Learners listen to the instruction from the teacher and do the activity after the instruction. Simple. You don't have to rush and what. Now, once you are done with the reinforcement, we come under conclusion. Conclusion, as you hear it, conclusion. Conclusion, it also takes 5 minutes listening and responding. So here you can either do a recap on the lesson, or you can do correction, or you can sing again, or retell the story for I mean that you told in the in introduction. So for okay, me here, I took a recap. So what did we learn today? I asked them question. What is means like what's the name of the animal we discussed? So then from there I close it with a song. So the teacher asks the question and gives a quick recap on the lesson, and the learners answer the question and listen to the recap. So the teachers lead the song. The song is Yemos. So the teacher leads the song. The teacher leads the song. The teacher leads the song and the learners sing along. So once you are done with that, I think you are all right. Now for the reflection form, the one you guys were saying, I will also do a video of it. Thank you.